to the channel. We would love that. Our dear Frank is going to stay on stage for a few moments because we're going to sing a song. We are not, but he is, to our moms in just a moment. And I just want to say a big thank you for our great moms here today. Happy Mother's Day. You are loved so well. You know, I know moms go through a lot. Amen? Okay. They go through a lot, you know, and they're deserving of this day. And I hope you love your mothers well today. If we would turn up the house lights, and I want to talk for a few moments about a song that Frank is going to be singing. How many of you ever heard the song, The Bridge Over Troubled Waters? Yeah, right? Okay, that was written back in the 60s. Oh, my gosh. And you know what? There was a lot going on in the 60s. How many of you were back in the 60s? I was just a little wee girl in the 60s. But a lot happened. Richard Nixon was the president. Bobby Kennedy and Martin Luther King was assassinated. The Vietnam War was going on, actually. I know Frank served in the Vietnam War. Who else? Anyone else serve in the war? Raise your Tony. Yes, Tony. That's right. So thank you guys so much. That was a real serious time in our world. And, you know, not a lot's changed from the 1960s to 2024. You know, I was just looking at things that are going on in our nation today. Our nation's in trouble. Look at the governmental issues going on right now, our safety, racism, the homeless, the crime, the violence, the election integrity. I mean, you know, it's just really sad what's going on in our world today, and we all covet prayers for America, right? But not only that, but among our children and our teenagers with social media right now, boy, it's a troublesome time with social media as well. I looked up just to see what's going on with social medias. What's the challenges for our children that are on phones at a very early age, right? And listen to this. There's child predators. There's scams, inappropriate and dangerous content. Oh, my gosh. Drug dealers, yes. There's sharing of posts that they regret later, right? There's misinformation. There's cyberbullying, harassment. There's 60% of the teenagers have experienced the harassment on social media. There's an exposure to ads that actually tell our kids who they are. You know, think about when they look onto the phone, what do they say? And not just our kids. This happens to us as well. But the measure up, you know, I got to measure up to this. It's so sad because I believe it's really wrecking our nation. Our kids are growing up on this thing so much that some of them, or I will say many of them, can't even make eye contact with adults or with other people. They have social anxiety that is just unbelievable in this hour. It deepens their insecurities, low self-esteem, depression, their self-image. Think about it. You name it. That's what they're faced with. How much more, as moms and dads, do we need to be praying for our children, praying for our nation, and the things that's going on in our world right now? So our children, and not only our children, but our married adults, they're going through the same things as well. Many disorders, lacking social skills, gender disorders, sex addictions. I mean, the story, the list goes on, and we all know that list and more of what we're facing today. And the children are begging for it. Let me have my own phone. You know, let me have my own phone. Oh, I'm telling you, we are just really facing some serious things in our society. So moms, I'll tell you, I'm going to give it up for you because in this hour, being a mom is tough. You know, being a mom is tough because you're having to face times in your life of making decisions with your kids that are doing nothing but just fighting back sometimes. Because you know what? Think about what the world, all of us are facing. You know, I thought about this. I thought if we took our Bible in one hand and our phone in the other, phone versus Bible, including all of us adults, how many times do we open our phone more than we do our Bible? Hello. All of us, 100% in this room, we open our phone more than we do our Bible. 100%, I would say. Wouldn't you? 100% in this room. Because we've got to see what's going on. Who called me? What's happening? Every minute of every day. And so our phone is dictating to our children and to us some pretty serious things in our life right now. You know, and that's not going to change. Because as time goes on, there's going to be better phones. It's going to get worse. And why is it going to get worse? Because it is the end of time. So how much more have we got to get serious about the things of God, teaching, training, and raising our children up in a culture that's going to teach them about God and put that first place in their lives? So as Frank sings this song today, as a mom, I want us to dedicate this song to our children. It's from our heart to our kids' heart.
When you're weary, feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. I'm on your side. Oh, when times get tough and friends just can't be found, like a bridge over troubled waters, I will lay me down, like a bridge over troubled waters, I will lay me down. When you're down and out, when you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your part. Oh, when darkness comes and pain is all around, like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down, like a bridge over troubled waters, I will lay me down. sail on
by. Your time has come to shine.
All your dreams are on their way.
See how they shine.
Oh, if you need a friend, I'm sailing right behind. Like
That is awesome, Frank. God bless you. Well, today that is exactly what we're going to be talking about. Is moms, you know what? You guys are a bridge over troubled waters. And you know, sometimes we feel like a bridge that's run over. We might not feel like a bridge that is appreciated. But I'm going to tell you something, moms. You are appreciated. And you know what? It's not you. And I'm not saying it's them either. But I'm going to say when trouble is around us, there's things going on inside of us. And sometimes those things that are going on inside of others can really affect us. Now, you know what? We all make mistakes, both our children and the adults. We all make mistakes. But you know what? You are appreciated. And I hope you appreciate your moms too. You know, I can remember the day that I was mad at my parents. I was so mad at my mother and father. And when I read the scripture where Jesus was kneeling down in the dirt and they brought the adulterous woman to him, and they said, Moses' law says to stone her. What do you say? You know, and Jesus said to them, if you're without sin, you can cast the first stone. And I realized at the time I read that scripture, I had a stone in my hand, and I would like to have thrown it at that time. At all the things that hurt me as a child, I wanted to throw it at my parents for walking out on me at the age of 12. But through that scripture, I got such a revelation that if you're without sin, you can cast the first stone. And all of a sudden, I saw myself. I am not without sin. Therefore, I cannot cast the stone at my parents. And then I had to realize, you know, they were who they were, and they did what they did because of what they went through as a child and from their parents, right? And so I forgave immediately through that scripture because I said, Lord, if you can have mercy on me, I can have mercy on them. And you know what I did? I released my rock. I put it back where it goes, back to the ground, right? So sometimes we have to do that by faith because I know some of us have gone through some things in our life that we say, you know, I don't know that I'm ready to let that stone go. Well, you know what? As long as we can't let it go, it's going to affect us. So if we want to continue to live in misery, we can continue to hold on to our stones. But when we want to be set free, we have to take an act of faith and we have to lay those stones down. Praise God. I had not planned to say that, but the Lord did. So what is a bridge? We say that we are a bridge. You moms are a bridge over troubled waters. This is someone who spans two cultures and consciously seeks to facilitate an exchange between the two. You know, if you don't know it by now, we think two worlds apart, don't we? We think two different ways. And as moms being that bridge, we try to connect the dots. We try to help our kids understand where we're coming from. And I don't care what age they are. We've been here long enough that we feel that we can put some things into their lives. We gave them life, but you know what? Jesus gave them new birth. So there's a purpose and a plan for us and the reason we gave birth to them. You know what? Here's what we've got to realize. We all have a call of God on our life in some form. We've all been called to the ministry of reconciliation. And we have to realize who our enemy is. It's not our children. It's not us. It's the enemy that tries to divide the home, right? And so he's going to use everything he can, from hurt feelings, being offended, hearing things the wrong way, to take down the purpose and the plan of God in our lives. So ladies, happy Mother's Day. You are well loved. The first point we want to look at today is this. Moms, you are a bridge of unconditional love. You know, you may think, well, I don't know that I have loved so well. I don't know that I've loved well. Oh, you have. Because you know what? Love sometimes hurts. I've discovered this year that love is grief. It's a new area of love. See, we talk about phileo and the erotic love, the friendship love. We talk about the different kinds of love, and we think that's all there is. But I discovered love is grief. Because if you love someone dearly, you hurt. And you know what? You could say, if you're not hurting, maybe we got to look at ourselves. You know, it's not to say we have to be hurting in order to love. But if we are hurting, it's because you love. Because if you didn't care, it wouldn't hurt, right? So you're a bridge of unconditional love. I love the first stanza of that very song. It said, when you're weary and you're feeling small, when tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. Isn't that what moms will do? They would come to their aid immediately when asked, right? Looking at the scripture in 1 John chapter 5, verses 1 through 15, I saw something new in this verse of scripture. Usually when I've read this verse of scripture, I always think about sickness. These people that are lame and blind. And listen to this. We're going to get something new out of this today. It says, after this, there was a feast of the Jews. And Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is in Jerusalem, by the sheep gate, a pool, which is called in Hebrew Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of sick people, blind, lamed, and paralyzed. Wow. You know what? When our kids deal with issues in their lives, no matter what it is, if they're hurt from separation from their parents, if they're hurt because they've been abused, if they're hurt because they've been abused in school, whatever reasons, whatever they're going through, you know what it does? It blinds them from the Word of God. It paralyzes them. It causes them to be lame. There's nothing they can do but have before their eyes the things they're going through, how frustrated they are. And you know what? It does things to them. What they see on social media, what they're involved in life with their peers, it causes them to not be able to see clearly what God has provided for them. And you know what? It cripples them. And then it cripples our relationship, because when they're crippled, what do? It looks like nag, 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 right? It looks like that. Because sometimes we get fed up to hear, I've had enough. I'm not dealing with you anymore. Goodbye. Would we say that? Some of us have. Why? Because they're lame. They're blind in some areas of their life. And we blame sometimes the child, the adult, when in reality, there's things that has caused them to be blind and lame. It goes, listen what they say. In this lay these type of people waiting for the moving of the water. Aren't our kids and us as well waiting on the move of the water, waiting on a move of the Holy Spirit to come in and transform our life? It says, for the angel went down at a certain time into the pool and stirred the water. Then whoever stepped in first after stirring the water was made well of whatever disease he had. Now a certain man there was that was at an infirmity for 38 years. Some of us, some of our children, they have had an infirmity for many years, but they can't get free from it. And when Jesus saw him lying there, he knew that he already had been in that condition for a very long time. We look at our kids' lives sometimes and we say, I've seen this from a little bitty thing. They've been in this condition for this long. How long, Lord, do we have to wait? What is it going to take, Lord? How long do we have to wait? So he knew he was in this condition for a long time. And you know what? Jesus asked him a question. Do you want to be made well? Do you want to be healed? Do you want to be delivered? What's wrong with you? Come on now. Do you want freedom? Or do you want to stay in that state you're in right now? Do you want it? And you know what the sick man said? Sir, I have no man to put me in the pool when the water is stirred up. But while I'm coming, another steps down in front of me. Doesn't that sound like the excuses we hear sometimes? Mama, I don't have anybody to help me. Mama, I don't have anybody to put me in the pool. Every time I get ready to get in the pool, somebody steps right in front of me, Mom. Mm-hmm. And Jesus said to him, get up. He didn't lay hands on him. He didn't reach down and pull him up. What did he say to him? He said, rise and take up your bed and walk. And immediately the man was made well, and he took up his bed and he walked. Doesn't that sound like us as moms? Stop doing that. Get up and walk right. What's wrong with you? You know better than this. Get up and walk. Take up your bed. How about make up your bed when you get out of it and pick up your underwear? It goes on to tell the story that Jesus later went into the temple and he actually saw the man in the temple. Praise God, he did take up his bed and he did something different. He went to the temple to be fed the word of God. And Jesus walked up to him and he says to him, hey, he says, sin no more. See, this was addiction that he had. And Jesus said, hey, don't sin anymore. Because if you do, there's a worse thing that's going to come upon you. Haven't we seen this sometimes in our children's life? When they get involved in things, they get addicted to something. Where does addictions take us? To the pit. You're a good mama. You're a good mama. Because you know what? Sometimes the way your kids can act, it can bring things out of you that you didn't even know was inside you. That could be a good thing, I suppose. Lord, help me get rid of that. I didn't know that was in there. I can remember telling one of my children, I won't tell you which one it was, but I can remember saying to them, you know what? I never act this way till I'm around you. You bring out the worst in me. You do not. You just think you do. You bring out the worst in me. Why do they do that? Because they're paralyzed. They're lame. They're blind. Now, I don't mean that in an ugly way toward them and putting our kids down. This is just family issues, right? We all, every one of us, face that, or we have faced it with our own parents. Because we get blinded by many things. Look at point number two. You, Mom, are the bridge that says you're always there. You're always there. I'm reminded of a reel I saw recently where a mom is putting on her shoes and puts her bag on her arm and her arm's full of stuff and she's headed out the door and her son calls. And she goes and lays down on the couch and props her feet up. And he says, what are you doing? Are you busy? Oh, no. Takes her bag off her arm. Because why? We would give anything to be with you. We would stop what we were doing. We would cancel an appointment. We would go with you where you wanted. We would help you in the best way that we can. Why? Because we love you. Good job, Mom, for always being there. Another part of the song says, when times get rough and friends can't be found. OCC, right now, they may need their friends. But there'll come a day they're going to need you. And you know what? We're going to be there for them. We're going to be there for them. He says, like a bridge over troubled waters, I will lay me down for you. And most of us would probably give our life if theirs was at stake. Because that's how much we love. Point number three is this. You are the bridge of comfort. What moms you are, that you bring comfort to your family. It says, when you're down and out, the song says, when you're on the street, when the evening falls hard, I will comfort you. Isn't that true, Mom? I believe every one of you in this room could check off that's true. I don't know of any of you that would say, I've been just an awful mother because I don't like my kids. Absolutely not. You've been a great comfort to your kids. And I have a verse of scripture for you here. You can just listen to it. It's not on the screen. But it is found if you want to look it up in your word. In 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 16 through 18, it says, moms, don't lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, yet inwardly we're being renewed day by day. For our light affliction, it's momentary. And it's achieving for us an eternal glory far outweighs everything else. So we are fixed. We fixed our eyes on not what is seen. But girls, we got to fix our eyes on what is unseen, what is temporary. Because you know why? The things that you see are subject to change. The things you see right now are subject to change. And some of us are at our wits' end to say, you know what? I'm right there and I'm ready to just quit and give up. Don't give up. Because you know why? You just don't know where they are in life. We may even think we know. But we don't know everything. Only God can know the heart of our kids. We can't even judge them for what's going on in their lives. Because you know what? We can only see the things they let us see. But we cannot see the deep places of the heart. So what is seen is subject to change. And what is unseen, which is our faith in God and the situation and the circumstances, that's why, girls, you have to set your face like a flint. That means you don't look to the left, you don't look to the right. You just look head on the promises of the Lord. This is what I stand on. This is what I'm going to believe. Right? And then the fourth point is this. Oh, isn't this good? You are the bridge of prayer. You're the bridge of prayer. That bridge of you, between you and your children, is one of prayer. How many prayers have you prayed for your kids? many, probably daily, huh? Many, many prayers that we've prayed for our children. And you know what, guys? These prayers go up before the Lord, and they mean something. They're not words that are just coming out our mouth that fall to the ground. These are words of faith that go before the Father. He hears these prayers, and guess what? They are active right now. The prayers you've prayed are active right now. Don't give up. Keep your eyes set on what God's told you. Keep your eyes set on the scriptures. They're working. I was thinking about, I looked up a few women and thought about of a few women that must have been in prayer. And I thought about Eve, who must have prayed from her heart when she was filled with such deep pain. Pain from a mother that lost her son to a senseless violence at the hand of another son. What must Eve have felt? The brokenness. A broken heart of losing one son, and then the other son would become paralyzed and blinded by what he had done. Where does that take him? What road does that take him down? You guys are quiet this morning. But it is a serious message. But it is a message, even though it's a serious message, it is a message of hope to say, you are a good mom. Don't be telling yourself anything any different. You are a good mother. I thought of Moses' mother. Her name was Jochebed. What a name. What must she have felt when she put the baby in a basket? Can you even imagine? Putting your newborn child in a basket and putting it in the water. I can't even fathom that. Grace, you're fixing to have a baby. You can't even fathom having to. When you hear that the government is going to kill all the boys within the next few days and you have a boy, what do you do with that? I'm going to go put my baby in the water. Do you think she was broken and crying out to God and praying from her deep innermost being? Absolutely, she was. And then Zarephath, you find in 1 Kings, who had enough flour and enough oil for her and her son to bake one more cake when Elijah showed up and asked for bread, asked for this. But because she was a woman of faith, she was praying and believing, and God showed up, right? And what happened? She was so blessed. Why? Because she was a woman of comfort. She was a woman of prayer. She was a woman of faith. And that's what you are. You moms are women of faith, comfort, love. Praise God. And then Hagar, who was sent away in the wilderness from Abraham and Sarah. How she grieved, she was hurt, she was broken, she was taken away from those that loved her and cared about her. She's a teenager, probably 15 years old, made to go to bed with a man that was 80. Imagine that. And then be okay about it. And then be sent away from them as an outcast. And then she cried out to God in the wilderness. She'd rather have died. But God redeemed her through her prayers. Isn't that lovely? And then what about Mary, the mother of Jesus? What must she have felt and prayed? How did things go for her son while he was here on the earth? She was a mama. She had to find him at the age of 12. He was nowhere around for 3 days. Imagine that. Your kid's missing for 3 days. And you find him at church 212. Praying at the altar. That's just where I was praying you would be, son. So she grew up with him, watching him go through all the agony, all the rejection by society, claiming that he is the Son of God, and having to walk beside him and see all these things happen, and then in the end to see him crucified, naked, hanging on a cross before his mother and the public, to be shamed and disgraced among everyone. These are some people that have had some really tough times as a mother. And I don't take lightly any of the things as moms that we have gone through at all. There are serious things some of us have been through, not only as a child, but as a wife and as a mother. And you know, I commend you, moms. Happy Mother's Day to you. And then all of your beautiful prayers that you've prayed. Maybe sometimes you need to just take the time to get your little notebook out and sit down and write out just some topics of what you've prayed about over your children. To remind yourself, I remember when I prayed this prayer. My prayer's constantly been on my lips before you, Father. And then to realize it's gone before him in faith. You know, there's a scripture in the Bible, some of you can look it up, but it states that when you groan, it is a prayer. You don't even have to say words. I went and visited Chris's grave this morning and took flowers. And when I knelt on his grave, I just put my hand down a few times and just hit it like this, because there was no words. Wasn't any words. Oh, I did say something. Melody was with me. And I stood up and I said, if you were alive right now, I would give you a whipping. <laughs> 46 years old. But you know what? I'm a firm believer because of the Word of God, that the prayers that were prayed over that boy all of his life, the scriptures that were read, the word of God that was spoken over him, he is with the Father. And you know what? I cannot live in the grief of not having him, but I can rejoice in the fact that he is with his dad and with the Father. Praise God. And you know what? The Lord will strengthen you. Whatever you're going through, whatever you've been through a lifetime of sorrow, the Lord will strengthen you. We just have to learn to be able to divide, and that comes from what we talked about, the spirit of discernment, the gift of discernment, that we have to divide between how long you can grieve and when you've got to stop. Now, that could go on for years, but you can't live in grief all day, every day, forever, because you know what? It'll begin to be like an addiction. It'll do the same thing to you as we just read. It will take you to a place you don't want to go. You will end up on the porch blind and lame and deaf and paralyzed. Can't go there. You got to find your happy place. And you know where that happy place is? It's with the will of the Father. Amen. God has a place for you. God has a place for you. And you know what? You won't find it unless you call out to him. And unless you're looking for him and seeking out the reason he saved you, you won't find it, because you'll be like everybody else. You'll be blind and lame and deaf and paralyzed, and you'll find yourself laying on the porch. And then you'll find yourself starting to say, nobody's here for me. I don't have a friend. There's nobody that can be found. He's there. Praise the Lord. I'm going to go back over here. No, I'm not. I'm going to go back over here. Thought I'd missed something, but I didn't. Point number five is this in closing. Jesus builds the bridge for you, mama. Isn't that great? He said in that song, sell on silver, girl. Sell on by. Your time has come to shine. All your dreams are on their way. See how they shine? And I love how he, the last stanza, he repeats, I'm like a bridge over troubled waters. He spoke that twice. But then he said, I will ease your mind. He said that three times in the song. I thought, how apropos. He wrote that back in the 60s for this sermon today. Amen. For us. Praise God. Because Jesus said, I am your bridge over troubled waters, mama. I am your bridge over troubled waters. And you know what? I am going to ease your mind. Isn't that lovely? I'm going to ease your mind. But you know what? We have to trust him. Now look with me in the Word in Isaiah 43. And we all know this scripture very, very well. But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you my name, and you are mine. Isn't that great? When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. And when you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. This is a promise from the Lord. Nor shall the flame even scorch you. Not only will you not be burned, you're not even going to be scorched. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I gave Egypt for your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in your place, since you were precious in my sight. You have been honored, mothers. And I have loved you. Therefore, I will give men for you and people for your life. Fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your descendants. Are you ready for this? Here's our promise. I will bring your descendants from the east. I hope Kim hears this morning, something she's trusting and believing God for. I will bring your descendants from the east, and I will gather you from the west, and I will say to the north, give them up. And to the south, do not keep them back. Bring my sons from afar and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I have created for my glory, I have formed him. Yes, I have made him. So you know what? The Lord will bring your loved ones back from every direction. If you're missing a relationship with some of those that you love right now, here's your promise in the Word. He's going to bring them back. Yes, thank him. If you've had an abortion and it troubles you, can I tell you something, Mama? They are being raised in heaven with the Father. They're alive. They're up there with my son. Praise God. Imagine being born in heaven. What a joy to be born in heaven. They escape this life. Praise God. It's a good way to look at it, isn't it? And guess what? We will be brought back together with them in time. That is a promise. The Lord says He's laying Himself down for you. He did this for you on the cross, and He is still your bridge today. You have not been forgotten, and you are not abandoned. He is always with you. Remain faithful and trust Him all the way to the cross. Praise God. And Jesus said in John 15:13, greater love has no man than this, than a man who would lay down his life for his friends. And that's what He's done for us. He's laid down His life for His friends. Believe in yourself, moms. Take these points and say them about yourself. You are a comforter. You are a lover. You are a prayer person of prayer. You are faithful. You know, my daughter was telling me, Leah, she said she was riding the airplane with her son when he was just a baby. And you know how they come on and they say, you know, if something were to happen, the mask is going to fall down. Put it over yourself first, then put it on your child. And she said, that's crazy. I'm going to put it on my child first. I'm going to put it on me first. But then she thought, oh, I get it. I have to put it on myself first so I can take care of him. So self-care is very important. But you know what? Not self-care is going and Googling these answers to say, how can I be a better self? There's nothing more powerful than digging right into the Word and finding out who you are there. Because you know what? That's when revelation rises. And when you get a revelation from the Word of God, you've got a revelation that will transform your life and will change your life. But see, Google and these self-help things will not save you and change you. It puts you on a performance treadmill that you have to do these things to get better. So you know what? We want to take care of our families. Continue doing what you're doing. Love them well. Amen. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord. If there's anyone here today that has never accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, right now is the time to do that. And it's very simple. Just say, Lord, forgive me of my sins. Wash me clean. I turn my life from the old life to a new life, and I'm going to serve you. And I would love for you to pray that prayer right now if you know you need to. You know how you know you need to? When the Holy Spirit stirs the inside of your belly, And it says, oh, something's wrong. Make it right before Him right now. Praise the Lord. I'm going to ask the moms to stand. I'm not going to ask you to come down here, but we're going to pray over you, and then I'm going to turn it over to Dennis. I'm going to pray over you, moms. Get our sweet mothers. God bless you, ladies. Thank you. Father, today we all, sitting and standing, pray for our moms. Thank you, Lord, for these great women of faith. Father, you knew them when they were just little girls. You knew them before they were even formed in the womb. You had a purpose and a plan for their life. And here they are, standing before you, Lord. You've seen each one and all the things they've been through, Father, in their life. The things they're standing up against right now, Father, the hardships that they're facing. And Lord, only you, God, can heal the broken heart. Only you, Father, can reach inside and restore the things they're concerned about today. Lord, thank you for loving us. Thank you for loving these sweet mamas, Lord. We ask, Lord, that you would keep your hand upon them, Father. Lord, we ask that you would heal their bodies, that you would heal their minds from the torment that they face sometimes. And Father, we thank you that you are their comfort and you are their strength. We ask, Father, for you to keep them by the power of your word. Sustain them, Father. Cause them to rise above their afflictions, Lord, and to be strong women of faith upon your word. And we just commit them into your hands, Lord, and we thank you that every day, including today, Lord, that you lead them and guide them and direct them by your Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless.